Sports. Our broadcast team tonight, on one side, Greg Anthony. On the other side, Steve Smith. And on the sideline, Dick Aldridge. I'm Kevin Harlan. It's the Chicago Bulls facing the New York Knicks. Now let's take a look at the Bulls' opening lineup. Longley out there with Dennis Rodman. And there's Harlan. It's Michael Jordan. And it's Pippen in at the small four.
Sky high. What a disadvantage of
him
as an undersized
four. Isaac from 19, and he connects with the jumper.
This is why you like to give him touches. He makes things happen.
Jordan, the pass to Pippen. And there's Michael Jordan, the assist by Pippen. Jordan's got his first points in this one.
And where's the help? Obviously, offensive rotation. Something in that green matchup.
Only the first quarter. Guys are getting in a groove, but communication on the defense has to be better.
And here are the Bulls now. And on our sideline, our reporter, Dave Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Yep, New York's head coach and I were able to chat. He knows they have to dig in on defense. They're facing a really talented offense. He said if those guys get going, we're going to be on the wrong end of some long runs. We have to be disciplined, work together, and make those second, third, and fourth efforts on plays. Whatever it takes to get a stop. We'll see if they can get a win in this first matchup between the teams this year. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks as always, David. Well, they know what their toughest job is going to be today.
Yeah, Kevin, it's hard to go up against a team that can light it up like this. You can't let them hit the ground running. You know what, Greg? You're right. So many of their games are decided in the first half because their offense starts clicking, they build up a big lead, and just run away and hide.
And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Outside for Pippen. Bulls moving the ball around. Back to Jordan. Back ball. Nice feed that time from Scotty Pippen. 6 points for Jordan.
Oh my goodness, 5 straight. And out of the game.
Anthony kicks to Ewing. Back to Anthony. Passes up to Heath. Hits it to go from beyond the arc. Houston's got himself on the board with 3 there.
Did they let him get that wild?
Pippen dishes to Jordan. Slammed in by Jordan.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. Stolen by Pippen. And here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way. He spins it down right on top of Amare.
Oh, that's an old-fashioned rim rack.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now. Now, here's Christian.
There. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
The Bulls leading by 7. Outside Jordan. Bulls shoot their first free throws of the night. He's off on the first. And he's good on the second. And here are the Knicks. Rodman brings the double team. Launches a three. It's good for his second make. He's made 2 or 3 so far.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
Well, obviously, this was the strategy coming in. Feed him the rock and let him go to work.
Here's Anthony, after Dennis Rodman's bucket there. Stoudemire setting the pick for Anthony. Pass to Houston from downtown. And it's Chicago with the rebound.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Conley can't get it to go.
You know what? He tried to lay it in at the point of attack. Just too much defensive pressure on that play.
And Chicago has possession. Leading by 5. Jordan gets the ball. Back to Jordan. James Jordan slides out. it loose. Harper, the pass to Rodman. He feeds it to Pippen. There's the pick. Back to Rodman. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen. Rodman's got six.
They're finding lanes into the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the bank.
Anthony gets the Ewing. Stoudemire against Rodman. Six to shoot. Pass to Stoudemire. Over Rodman. Conley grabs the miss.
I can tell you right now, the coach loved everything about that shot except the result.
Methodical in their approach. They have absolutely owned this first quarter.
My opinion, it's been the commitment to pounding the ball inside. That's what's given them the upper hand.
And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here. Michael Jordan really having a great game.
You know, he's been a one-man breaking through down low. His consistent scoring has dictated the pace of this game. We'll see if they decide to front him, bring a quick double, or maybe even both to try to slow him down.
Reeves checked in for Stoudemire. Here's Harper, following the score by Walt Frazier. Rodman in the post. Reed covering it. The shot by Rodman, no good.
Yeah, the aggressive D inside leads to a missed opportunity there.
You know, he had a terrific position, does a good job of defending the shot without fouling.
And this is one of those times where the coach has got to preach, be unselfish.
And we don't know that he hasn't. Maybe it's been falling on deaf ears.
Bitch.
And guys, they've come out and established a rhythm. And also their play calling has been on point.
Well, the two go hand in hand. Matching your strategy to your personnel is key.
A nice shot by Frazier. The Bulls leading by nine. 3 seconds separate the shot clocking being and they pick up two. And that's now 17 points for Jordan.
And 10 of their last 12 coming off assists.
Feeds it to Reed. Here's Houston. And the three off target. And here we go. The Bulls fetch break. A shot by Jordan, no good. Anthony. The shot, no good. And so it's the Chicago Bulls. They're leading 11 points to end the quarter. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of the points coming right at the rim. Back high after this. Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And the Bulls guy is a... And so it's New York with it. 11-point game. And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor. All fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. And New York, looking at who they got. King is out there with Reed. Then there's Frazier. Then there's Richardson. And it's Ewing in at center.
And really keeping the ball, hopping around here offensively.
A screen from you. The pass to King. The dish to Reed. Stolen by Pippen. Here's Longley. And he's fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for him offensively.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Tony Allen's checked in for Michael Jordan. Free throw, good, Longley. Knicks trail by 16. Richardson picks the lead. Ball's not loose. Allen, right side. Passes to Longley. Some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Great defense that time from Hewitt.
And on some plays, everything goes your way, except for the finish. Bad communication defensively. This is the last guy you want to leave open from there.
Here's Kukoc. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out.
Wow, he doesn't make plays like that very often. That's a nice move inside.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
Yeah, the amount of points they've given up here today, that's what they've got to talk about.
Even for the most part, the perimeter is holding up. They might have to sacrifice some of that to close down the lane.
Williams, he's checked in for Chicago. some action here in the second quarter. Lead a screen. Here's Frazier. Good coach with the rebound.
Yeah, you love the solid screen, but what you hate is just the inability to finish. You can see he's frustrated with that one. Nose is up to him to make that play.
Right at the free throw line. A 10 short, but it's good off the front iron. Kane's got five now.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Curler can't hit. Knicks trail by 13. Ring shot on the way. It's a tip. It's good as a putback. He's got his first touch of the night.
He did a stellar job throwing his body into the mix and coming up with the easy tip in.
Barnett, he's checked in for the Knicks. Harper, he's checked in for Chicago. Here's Pittman. And again, no good by Chicago. So the Bulls, the last game, a win against the Trailblazers in Portland. The feed to Reed. A 15-footer, and again, it's New York. Chicago leading by nine. Here's Pippen. Off target at the rim. Pippen's gone 1-3 on the night. King, the pass to Ewing. Double team on Ewing. Kukoc with the steal. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. That one's not going to go. The Knicks go the other way. And the guarder is Richardson. Reed dishes to Richardson. And he finishes nicely on the way. Richardson's got his first 2 points.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic. It is a big part of why they win again. He's been good.
Now the Knicks with it. Stringing it together. They've got an 11-2-1 goal. Point loose. Here's Barnett, and oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. First trip to the line for him here. That's good for Barnett. He's going to check in for you. Dennis Rodman, he's checked in for the Bulls. And both free throws good for Barnett. The Bulls win by 5. Here's Harper. That's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Work to get it inside and draw contact.
For Chicago, they have made 2 of the previous 3 in today's game. And so he makes both from the line. Richardson with it. It's from Nolan to the other left. Here's Reed. That one falls. Coming off Anthony's feet. Anthony's got his 4 assists on the night. To the left wing. Going outside, beyond the arc. No good that time.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making a lead coverage.
Not loose. Kukoc with the steal. He tries for 3. Harper's shot's good. Harper's got 5.
With this lead, we're playing confident and showing a good trigger from beyond.
Yes, pretty high post. In the corner is Richardson. And again, it's New York. And there's a minute 45 left to play here in the second quarter. Harper kicks it to Walsh. Fades and shoots. And the Bulls, another 3.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
And then it gets down. Here's Anthony. Rodman grabs the miss. The Bulls winning by 9. Allen kicks to Rodman. Back to Allen. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Like seeing the activity from Tony Allen down low. No one scares this guy, even when he's taking it amongst the trees.
And here's Anthony from the arc. These guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice decision.
And when everyone's involved offensively, it has a way of helping you on the defensive side as well.
And Williams gets it to go on the edge by Kukoc.
That's an excellent pass. On time, on target. Great teamwork.
Got a piece of it. There's the double team with Allen. Pass to King. 23 seconds left in the second quarter. Here's Kukoc. He's got five. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Kukoc has got seven.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the lane.
Here's Richardson. Offensive struggles continue, missing again. And so Chicago, their lead at 15 going into the break. What a night they've had in terms of their shooting. Everything dropping in for them.
Two quarters. They lead by 15. Kenny, what did you see from them?
Well, they just about ran their offense to perfection. They carried the ball inside, and the entry feeds were on time and on the money. It was a clinic to watch. The second half is going to be no contest if they keep getting shots 8 feet in.
Jack, what'd you think about New York?
The first thing to say is, what's up with the turnovers? Jeez. You can live with some missed shots and stuff like that, but you can't keep turning the ball around. It's crushing for a team. It just saps all your confidence when you play a half like that. Right? Ugh.
The wall of the Canal Street subway station in Soho, south of Houston, is down the way from us. In fact, Angie, now it's been a one-team show so far. Here is Frazier. So the way is five right now. They've got Pippen. 5 minutes out, good one. That's Michael Jordan. That's Harper at the point guard position. Anthony kicks to Ewing. It's all in by the Bulls. Pippen, the pass to Rodman. It's going by Stoudemire. Pippen against Anthony. Dishes it to Frazier. Kicks it to Ewing. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there. This is his first free throw of the game. That's good from Ewing. That one falls, so he hits both of them. The Bulls leading by 13. Parker the pass to Longley. Here's Jordan. Plays it up and banks it in. Jordan's got 19 points.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Anthony. Pass to Houston. Back to Anthony. Knocked away. And it's out of bounds to New York. They'll retain possession. And if you're just joining us, we play over a minute here in the third. Buries it from 3-point range.
When he gets it going from out there, look out.
Outside Jordan. He's tipped. Here's Frazier. This will have a play, but it's good. He'll go to the line.
Getting the half off to a good start here already with some penetration. Those are the kind of looks you want to get coming out of the break. Get it in tight. Get those high quality chances in the paint.
Here's Jordan. It's hauled in by Ewing. Ewing's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Anthony dishes to Frazier. Back to Anthony. Plays it up and banks it in. Anthony's got 5 points now this quarter.
And all of a sudden, the shots now falling in bunches. The reflection of this game has completely changed. Yeah, reason why they have found their shooting stroke. Their offense is clicking.
Chicago shooting their 6-7 free throws in the game. And the Bulls making a change here. First checked in, and that's good as he gets both of his shots. Knicks trail by 9. Stoudemire, the screen. Ewing kicks to Stoudemire. Frazier right side. Over Kerr. And he can't bank that one in. Here's Jordan. And replay review now commonplace. In the interest of speeding up those reviews, Steve, the league last season, allowing officials at the replay center in Secaucus, New Jersey, to make the call. You like that decision?
You know I do, but I think sometimes finding a way to speed it up, and I think there's some way where you can have the referee right there on site also can be able to get a chance to see the play, because sometimes technology doesn't get back from Secaucus back to the game.
in some kind of way, the middleman, if he's there, in his obvious play, that can cut the time. You know, because right now, sometimes it's taking a long time.
As long as they get it right, correct? How they do it, who cares? As long as they get the call right, though, to me, it's not
good. I love that, Kevin, but I think sometimes, you know, human error is a part of basketball. The refs can't be perfect. And so sometimes if they're a bad call, it's just a bad call you got to live with.
Chicago leading by 11. Outside Pippen. And there's the pass to Longley. Six on the shot clock. Kerr kicks to Pippen. Off target from outside. Pippen's gone. 1 for 5 from the field. 20%. Starks, right side, over Jordan. A shot by Starks. No good. Here's Chicago. At 1 point, they led by 16. Pippen kicks to Kerr. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. The tray, and Pippen with the basket. The assist by Kerr. Pippen's got his second bucket of the night.
And each bucket at this point feels like a backbreaker. Showing no mercy. Double-digit lead and still putting it on.
Baseline jumper. Here's Rodman. Nice work on the board. He's paying off with the basket. Rodman's got 8 points.
Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
Here's Ewing. That's tipped. And they're pushing up. There's Kerr from the arc. That one, no good. And New York the other way now. Over to the wing. Here's Frazier. Got a piece of it. Jordan against Starks. Now here's Jordan. Guarded closely. Goes up and lays it nice and easy.
Well, if you wonder why they're in control of this game, just look at his stats in the field. Solid, solid, solid.
Here's Houston. Connects from 3-point range. 9 points in the game so far.
This is what these perimeter plays are designed to produce. Quality looks for spot-on shooters. He's been making plays all quarter on a terrific hot streak, helping to build out this lead.
Frazier kicks to Stoudemire. Over Rodman. A shot's good from Stoudemire. Here's Pippen. He has 5. And Rodman with the dunk.
Dropping dimes all night. He's been completely locked in.
Unselfish basketball. That'll make you very popular amongst your teammates.
Starts the pass to Ewing. Over Longley. Ewing can't hit. Chicago leading by 17. Here's Pippen.
Bitch.
Pippen slamming it down.
Haven't we seen that a few times today, guys? I mean, their defense has got to have a little bit more toughness.
They took a pick. Stoudemire, the screen. Tipped away.
Ooh.
And how about just floating to the rim on that slam?
He gets up. I mean, he gets up.
Nasty.
A highlight reel replay brought to you by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. Excellent work by the talented people in our production truck as well. Here's Chicago. They're on a 19-5 run. Jordan, and he drops it in from the low post. Jordan's got 12 points in just the second half.
Extended the lead. This has been a great year for him off.
Fuck out of here.
And it's out of bounds to New York. They'll retain possession. Good work from New York. He's stepped in for Stoudemire. And King subbed in for Starks. And a change for the Bulls. Harper's checked in. 30 seconds left to play in the third. Get a hand on it. Jordan inside. And the dunk by Jordan.
And everything they're attempting is going in. Tremendous run here in the third.
Something went on in that locker room. They've come out aggressive, but also extremely focused.
Stolen by Ewing. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out.
Now that's one of his specialties. Just squaring up from medium range.
Yeah, he has the height to shoot over most any defender ever touched to make it with consistency.
And so Chicago in very good shape with a 23-point lead at the end of the quarter. And they're winning the turnover battle very easily in this one. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
The Bulls leading by 23. They got Anthony. He's out there with King. Frazier is out there with Reed. And it's Houston at the two spot. That's the five for New York right now. New York with the ball. And King, here we go. Frazier against Harper. Frazier dishes to Reed. Inside.
Fuck out of
here. On that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's been this year the NBA choosing to start the season a bit earlier to cut down on the back-to-back games during the year. Do you think the NBA should spread the schedule out even more? Are you happy the way they have at least gone about this season?
I think the NBA, Adam Silver and those guys have done a fantastic job. I love how they give the guys basically a week after All-Star game. They're starting a little bit early to cut down the back-to-backs. Either way, you can find ways to help the recovery time is great. But I think right now, the league and the games and the scheduling, they're in good hands right now.
Count that one.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
King outside. This is up to Houston. He gets to Carmelo. Not loose. Five to shoot. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Anthony's got four this quarter.
And with that matchup, doing what he was able to do there, just muscling inside, he's not going to have a lot of problems.
Harper. And what was that about? Not a good shot right there. Frazier kicks the ring. Now here's Rodman. Here's King. Plays it up off the glass.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
Here's Jordan. Jordan's got 33.
He's in control when it matters, giving them a tremendous advantage right here.
New York calls timeout, and the initial rules for the NBA included six personal fouls as the magic number before you're done for the game. It's been this way since, you know, who can remember? But do you think six is the right number, Steve, for fouls? Or would you like to see them raise or lower
it? I definitely wouldn't want to see them raise it. I think seven would be too much. Maybe if they lower, that's a possibility, but right now I think it's six. Maybe five, or maybe you can experiment during some preseason games or in summer league. But I think six should be the maximum.
Oh!
Jordan's got 35.
Still attacking. Building on this lead coming down the stretch. And he's doing it efficiently. Taking makeable shots. That's led to a high percentage from the field. A slight rebound advantage.
Bitch!
He's putting on a show for these fans.
I can't believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Feeds it to Reed. Pippen against King. He dishes it to Carmelo. 11 feet away, he can't get it to go. And it's Chicago the other way. Here's Jordan. And slammed up by Jordan.
And the point differential tells the story. Their two-way play has been outstanding.
You know, it's a matter of effort plus talent. You need both to dominate this way.
Now, Reed. On the run, Chicago grabs the miss. Hoffman's got six rebounds here tonight. And slammed up by Jordan.
Yeah, and in terms of accuracy, they are dominating the second half.
I like that they're trying to maximize the value of each possession. And you know their coach likes it.
Here's Houston, and he drops that one in. Now the Bulls with it. Giving up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Here's Jordan.
That's a beautiful jam.
He has taken it upon himself to score the ball as much as possible for his team. He's not looking to pass it right now.
Anthony up on top. And across the NBA, we've seen players taking a vocal stance on various social issues. Do you think that's pretty important?
Very important. And I think this generation has done it better than my generation. obviously speaking out, but yes, they're using their social media tools to come out and talk about important issues. The one thing you want, you just want to bring light to these issues, and hopefully a lot of people, the more light you bring, the more solutions I think will come about.
Well said. How about the screen that frees him up, though, for the jump?
Here's Jordan, and he lays it straight in. Jordan's got 47 points.
Up by a bunch. He's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
With this big of a deficit in the score, you think the losing team will be playing harder?
Nope, opposite.
Shot from 12. That one off the back iron and out.
Well, this is what happens when you're a threat down low. You attract a lot of defensive attention.
Kept alive, Longley, and terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two.
Guys, he's having a ball up there. I mean, we knew going in that he had an advantage on the glass, but I didn't think he could be this dominant. What a difference. And he's not going to back off. Even with that big lead, he's going to get more motivated to keep stretching out their lead.
Left side, Jordan. Four seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Jordan's got 49 points in the game.
And just staying aggressive, continuing. Maybe they have no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
So New York ends up going with the new group. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Williams, he's checked in for Longley. Simpkins comes in for Rodman. Tony Kukoc, he's checked in for Scotty Pippen. And Kerr is subbed in for Ron Hunter. Seconds left to play in the final quarter. Stoudemire, the screen. Here's Barnett. That's a big high pass and goes in.
And you can see there, the defender allows himself to get picked. You know, it's all about effort. Sometimes you're going to get hit on hard screens. You just have to fight through them.
Jordan's shot is off. We've got 22 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Barnett, and out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
Poor timing on that play calls it the turnover.
Chicago with the ball. Here's Jordan. That shot missing. Some solid defense right there from Starks. Richardson up top. And so Chicago takes this one and by a big margin. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. Now, for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldrin, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. See you later.